point, we have been able to eliminate the reported established relationship between Joanne Taylor and Mr. Skelton. Based on recent information that we've gathered from a number of sources, that window of time that I talked about previously between 2:30 Thursday afternoon to Friday at 1:30, we believe that the vehicle that Mr. and Mrs. Skelton own, a 2000 Dodge Caravan, blue in color, could potentially have been away from the residence during that period of time in question, and in the Morenci area, and then down near Funkel, Ohio, Unity, Ohio, West Unity, Ohio, and Holiday City, Ohio. I have pictures here today of the vehicle. Digital images will be available after the press conference. Sandra Berchtold from the FBI's Media Relations will be collecting your emails, and at this point forward will be your liaison with our command post. You're welcome to take these copies or provide that information to her. We have fixed wing aircraft coming in again today to search the areas that I just mentioned, that area in Williams County and up towards here to Morenci. We will also continue with the agents that we have and the officers and deputies following up on all the leads that come in. So we are asking that anyone in that area specifically that I just mentioned that's seen that vehicle, the boys, or John, or anyone with these boys, to contact the tip line here at the police department, 517-458-7104. I'm mentioning the time frame of 2:30 Thursday afternoon until 1:30 Friday. Any of those times, but keeping in mind a time frame also to help you narrow it down a little more potentially would be from like 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. maybe. I want you to keep the full time frame in mind, but that would be a helpful, a little more narrow time also. The searchers that we have here at Morenci Fire Department will be establishing a secondary staging area at the Pioneer, Ohio Fire Department to assist with the searches in that area. Searchers that want to continue to volunteer and help are strongly encouraged to still arrive here so they can check in with the process so we can track the folks that we have on the ground working and coordinate with our Morenci Fire Chief staff on that. As far as future press conferences go, we will continue with 11 a.m. Every day until the situation is resolved or further direction comes from me. In the event new information comes out, I would strongly encourage you to get your emails to Sandra so we can blast that out to you, or if we need to schedule an impromptu conference, we can get that information out as well. I'd be willing to take a few questions here.
Chief, can you tell us what's leading you down to those communities in Ohio, Holiday City? Is this from information you've received from Mr. Skelton, or what is it that's moving you into that area?
We've collected information from a number of sources. Those particular sources is not information I can provide at this time.
Did they mention if they had family or what they thought he was doing?
Chief, you said that you've eliminated the relationship between the father and this woman. Do you know if this woman even exists? And if so, did you speak to her? And if not, do you think the father has talked to any other individual?
Specifically to the Joanne Taylor subject, we can confirm that there's no established relationship between he and person that he described to us as Joanne Taylor.
Does that mean she doesn't exist?
Well, we've received a number of tips into the tip line from citizens that have done research on the internet. You can find a number of Joanne Taylors out there. So to say that a Joanne Taylor doesn't exist would be negligent. What I'm saying is a reported relationship between Mr. Skelton and Joanne Taylor does not exist.
So he lied about that.
Correct.
And then the second half of my question, sir.
Have you confiscated his computer to see, to track any kind of conversations he might have had with a Joanne Taylor? Is he still being cooperative?
We continue to have conversations with Mr. Skelton and all the parties involved in this to collect any and all information we can have. We also have done searches at the home, which would be standard any type of incident like this, and collected a number, I shouldn't say number, things from the home to assist us with our investigation. That would be all the information I can provide.
Do you believe
a bit about the car? I mean, if you could just kind of give us an idea again as to what exactly it is about this vehicle and this description, people should be keeping in mind. Where was this car and when and who was believed to be in it?
Well, I'm providing the information because we believe that potentially the boys, Alexander, Tanner, and Andrew were in the vehicle that morning or the evening before. And the reports we have would indicate that vehicle was not at the home during some of the time in question here. So since we can last pinpoint the boys in the backyard on Thursday afternoon, and that we know that the vehicle wasn't at the home at a period of time there, we certainly would want any leads that we could gather for that period of time on where that vehicle is at. Were the boys in the vehicle? Did anyone see that vehicle? So that's where we would go with that.
Do you have any idea, are the kids still safe? Do you have any idea their status and their well-being right now?
Well, we remain hopeful. That's why we're doing what we're doing here, that we're going to find these boys and bring them home.
What led you to the 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. window there on Friday morning?
The information developed there is not something we're going to be releasing at this time.
What's the condition of John Skelton, and is he still hospitalized?
I don't know specifically any developments beyond information I originally disclosed as far as a minor fracture of the ankle suffered during his reported attempt at suicide. Beyond that, I don't have any.
But is he still hospitalized right now?
He remains in the custody of a mental health facility.
Is he under suicide watch?
I don't know the answer to that, but certainly because of the situation, we maintain constant contact.
If he did try to commit suicide, do you know why?
Is he able to leave upon his own will if he wanted to? His grandmother told me that he was in a locked facility. Could he leave if he wanted to? Or is he?
He remains secured in that facility.
By your direction? Authorities' direction?
In accordance with the procedures set forth during any time someone attempts to harm themselves.
Because of the mental condition or because of what's gone on with the social support?
In connection with his mental health, that situation.
Why did he try?
Unfortunately, I don't have any time for additional questions. Again, please contact Sandra to forward that information. Again, I apologize. I know many of you have been to my office over the last several hours trying to glean information. It is not my intent to deprive you of information, but more so the lack of my desire to apply a great deal of resources to communicate with you folks, and we need agents and officers out in the field to collect information. Sandra would be glad to assist you from this point forward. Thank you for your time.